Hi there, my name is Andy Young and I'm one of the automotive lecturers down at Unitech in Auckland, New Zealand, and welcome to my Andy Mechanic YouTube channel. Now this particular video is a little bit different to what I normally get involved with, to be perfectly honest. One of my customers dropped off a great heap of stuff for me to fix, quad bikes, a couple of motorcycles, and on his trailer was this thing. It's a petrol powered sweeping machine. Now, I've never worked on one before, and it's come in because he has a problem with it. It's lost drive to the bristly bit at the front, so it doesn't sweep anymore. It drives around just fine, but it doesn't sweep anything up anymore. Well, I say sweep it up, it actually doesn't have a collector thing on it. It just keeps sweeping it wherever you end up. I suppose a big pile of rubbish at the front. We're going to have to fix it. I have no idea how it works. Well, obviously it's got an engine, but I have no idea how the output from the engine gets to the wheels and gets to the rotary bristles at the front, you know. So a bit of a learning curve for me, and hopefully we can get it fixed for him so he can get sweeping again. Here we go. Okay, well, I'm assuming that under this plastic cover is some kind of drive mechanism. So let's take a look. I have to admit, this is the first time I've ever worked on anything like this. And I do my very best to stay well away from lawnmowers. I had no idea this was coming down. It just sort of turned up. Okay. Okay. Easy. Right. Let's run through what we've got. Okay, well, by the looks of it, we've got two drive belts. This one here, the one nearest the engine, is a toothed belt, and that one does the drive to the wheels. Okay, and this one, which is currently loose, does the drive to, yeah, to the brushes. Okay, so nice. So let's get it fired up and see why there's no drive to the brushes, because this belt seems just fine. And I can't imagine the crankshaft has snapped, so this has got to be turning regardless. Looks like a pretty standard V-belt, this one. Okay. So what happens when we engage drive to the brushes? Ah, okay. So this cable here is linked to the lever on the handle. And so I'm saying that basically when that's on the handlebars, tight on the lever, this drive belt should be tight, and it's slack. Well, if it's slack, it's not going to transfer any drive, is it? Okay, well, let's fire it up and just double check.
On. And choke is left. And fuel is on. With a bit of prime. God, it could end in disaster with this.
Okay, so we can see quite clearly that the crankshaft was spinning, as was the drive belt here for the wheels to drive, but that the clutch wasn't engaged. And this drive belt to the brushes for these two pulleys was slack, even when I engaged drive on the handlebars. So, either there's some adjustment or that belt's worn out. And given the fact that it's still really slack, I think it needs a new belt. Let's take the belt off and measure it. Okay, well, there's a lot of slack on this belt, so we should just be able to lift it clean off, I reckon. Right, that's that off the pulley. Now, we just need to get it off that big pulley, the output down the bottom. Tell you what, we'll take the bottom plate off, and that'll give us some more access. somebody's out and about today. Oh, there's a lot of rubberized sort of dusty stuff all over the place, giving us an idea that that belt's going to be pretty worn, actually. There, that's a lot better. Okay, now there's a bit of a guard that stops the belt from coming off. Oh, there we are, look. Right, there we are. Okay, give it a tug. Mint. Right, over to the bench and let's inspect this drive belt. Okay, well that was quite an easy job, wasn't it, getting this drive belt off? And, well, first of all, it's lost a lot of rubber. And so I've just turned it inside out to give it a good inspection. It's not perished, it's not very old. It doesn't look particularly serviceable. Again, there's a lot of rubber that's come away from the outside of the belt as well, where it rubs on those tensioners. But this should be a good indication when you're measuring V-belts. I'm pretty sure this is a 10mm belt, is to measure across here, because as the sides of the belt wear, this distance across here gets smaller. There. Looks about 10mm to me. Strange. Okay, where's my verniers? Okay, so we'll set those to zero. And, ooh, okay. Maybe it wasn't a 10mm belt at the start of its life. Because at the moment it's 11.69. So maybe it was a half inch belt. Jeez. Let's just measure a new one. Okay, new belt. 10.35. That's a 10mm, what we call a 10mm car fan belt. That's not wide enough. Shit. That's not bloody good, is it? Okay, let's go measure the pulleys. Okay, well, the pulleys can cut with a belt only up to about 12mm, really. Okay, 12.5. Let's go see if we can find an old Petrol drive belt, and that'll give us an idea if a half-inch belt will fit in that pulley happily enough. Okay, well, this is an old belt. This is a 13mm half-inch belt. Yeah, that sits in there real well, doesn't it? Damn. Okay, and if we were to put on the 10mm belt, the smaller one, you can see it sits a lot lower in the actual pulley itself. So I don't think that's going to work. I think we'll do a lot better to get a half-inch belt. Okay, time to get some parts. Right. Much traffic queuing later. So tempted to go to the pub this afternoon, but hey, I'm back. I managed to get two belts. I was only able to get a 650mm long belt. I think that's way too short. I couldn't get a 660, but I was able to manage to get a 675mm belt. That's the Bosch one. I think we'll start with this one. Hopefully it's going to be the right size, because nobody had a 660 in stock. Okay, so let's head over to the sweeping machine and work out how the hell we're going to get this new belt on, because this belt, don't forget, is a lot wider now than the one we took off. This is 13mm wide, whereas the original one had worn down to about 11mm. Much easier to get off, but didn't work. Alright, now the first job, I think, is if we engage the lever for drive to the wheels, this clutch, or this drum here, is going to move backwards slightly and give us a bit more room to get the belt in down the side of this pulley. So we'll do that first. Okay, don't want to be starting it up right now because it's going to go flying forwards, but that's going to give us a bit more space to get down there with the new belt. Right. Here goes. Now, I did take the little bolt, the guide piece, I took that off as well a bit earlier on, because I thought that might make things a little easier for us. It's not the easiest task in the world, is this? Okay, right. So now all we need to do is get that up and onto that pulley. So I'll get a 10mm spanner, then we can roll it on. Okay. Bit of a cheap way of doing it, but it does work. Okay, there we go. Right, good. Okay, so we've got a bit of slack in that belt, which is what we need, because don't forget, when this pulley here, the engagement tensioner pulley, isn't applied, we want this to freewheel, because this is going to spin. This is the crankshaft. We need this belt to be stationary. It's not really a very good design. It's something similar to what Ben has on his John Deere lawnmower, to be honest, and that thing eats belts as well. Not really ideal. Okay, so... Right, there's a tensioner spring that's dropped off down the bottom. I'll flick that back on again. And then hopefully we can get this thing fired up. Put the cable back on the lever on the handlebars, and give it a test. Okay, so with these, you pop that into there like that. And then we just, it's not like a motorbike cable where it's got an outer as well. It's just got the inner. It's a bit Heath Robinson, to be perfectly honest. Sorry, Heath. Okay. Right. Oh dear, we have another problem. Now, where this cable comes down from the front on the handlebars, it runs through a couple of pulleys. Now, the rear pulley's fine, but this one here, the cable is cut right through the plastic. So I'm going to whip the bracket off and we can take a closer look. Man, the quality of this machine is just, it's just shocking, isn't it? Designed to work for one day. A bit like Steve Robb's 10-hour chainsaw, wasn't it, Steve, that you were mentioned? The problem with this kind of machinery is you can spend so many hours just fettling it and trying to get it to work, well, trying to get it to work at all, in all honesty. And it's very difficult to charge out those hours because, you know, the machine wasn't that expensive to start off with. It just sort of kills the whole thing. It's far better to buy a decent bit of kit. It's going to last you for years and years and years. And one that you don't have to just keep fettling all the time. Right, that's the bolts out of the way. What have we got? We can see there, look, the cable's trapped and it's gone behind that wheel. Oh, look at that. Look at the state of that pulley. No wonder this thing wasn't working properly. Okay, so we're going to have to, I think, machine up on the lathe a new pulley. I'll tell you what, I won't make it out of plastic either. See if we can find a bit of aluminium that'll do the trick. Right, I will come back, hopefully, with a new pulley. Okay, I came up with an even quicker fix. We've got an old inner bearing race in the middle with a couple of washers either side, and that should be enough to allow that cable to slide around. That's hardened steel, so it'll be all right. It's pretty low friction, so we'll just hook that cable into there. It should sit in that middle groove there, look, should be good. And we're going to bolt that back on. Oh, sorry, camera. Been one of those days today. This was just supposed to be a quick fix. Never. Not with Chinese stuff. Now the other pulleys don't look much better, to be honest, and this cable was actually plastic coated, but I noticed that some of the plastic coating had got separated from the cable and it was also causing it to jam and just not work freely, so I got a blade and just cut all that off. Stupid idea. I suppose the idea is good, but the quality is just shocking. It just separates after a while. Can't cope with the tension. A lot better off just being
basic cable. Right, let's get this one on. Better not over tighten them, they'll probably snap. Okay, right, I'll just get a bit of spray grease and we'll chuck a bit of grease onto that contact point there. Right, doesn't get any on the belts, that's for sure. Perfect. Well, that's pretty good. I like that. So when it's on, it's pretty tight. When it's off, there should be plenty of movement on there for it to slip. Okay, I think it's time to give it a test. And that spring is still on down the bottom. Brilliant. Okay, let's get this thing fired up. See, get that that front belt adjusted best we can. Ignition is on. Ooh, a bit of choke. Okay, well that's the belt fully slackened off and there's still drive going to the front brushes. I don't think it's possible to fully disengage those brushes. At least it's got drive. Okay, so I'm going to tension it up so that when the lever's pulled in, the belt's nice and tight so that it's not going to slip. Whatever it is when he's not pressing the lever on the handlebars, it's the way it's going to be, unfortunately. Okay, here we go. So I'm just tightening up the adjustment now, and you'll see the adjuster wheel going towards the belt.
Day it's been to fix something that can sweep the floor instead of you doing it. I did actually fix it. I was quite surprised. What I'd done is I'd left the there's a little adjustment wheel for the height of the brushes, and they were basically off the ground with no resistance. So the belt, the friction between the belt and the pulleys, even though the belt was really slack, was still enough to turn those brushes around. As soon as I lowered the brushes down with the concrete, massive amounts of friction, and then it starts to slip on the belt just fine. As soon as I engaged drive using the left-hand lever on the machine, it tightened up the belt pretty good actually, and there was a momentary slipping of the drive belt, which is what Ben gets with his John Deere tractor as well when he engages the cutters, the deck underneath the lawnmower. But as soon as it's up to speed, there was absolutely no slippage whatsoever. And if there's no slippage, should be anywhere. So really, it's down to the chap to adjust it on a regular basis. So all in all, yes, looks like Andy Mechanic can just about fix sweeping machines, but I won't be doing any more. Don't think so. Stick to my quad bikes and stuff, I think. Now, the belt that actually fit was what I thought it might be, which was 13A0675. That's 675 millimeters in length and 13 mil or a half inch wide belt. It took me ages to get hold of that. And it does have electric start, but it's a mains, it's a mains powered electric start. And obviously it's not lawful in New Zealand, so the suppliers have cut off the power lead, so you can't plug it into the mains to get the thing started. So you've got to use a hand pull. I have never seen a mains powered starter motor before. Most bizarre. Oh well, makes it interesting, doesn't it? What else have I learned from it? It's Chinese, isn't it? Every nut, every bolt, every thread, every component. It's just 3 out of 10. Sorry, but it is. And they're just not nice to work on. I used to work on bicycles for the first year I came to New Zealand. I got to be a Shimano mechanic. And you get people bringing down, you know, I can't name any names, but the bikes that you buy in boxes, and can you build this up for me, please? Well, I can assemble it, but it's not going to be a bicycle at the end of it because it's just so rubbish. And I sort of get the same sort of feeling with this as well. It's just, yes, it works today. I'm going to deliver it back to the customer tomorrow. And yes, it's going to work for a while, but it's not going to work for very long. Something else will break. And it just doesn't make me feel very good as a mechanic. You know, I've sort of tried to make it work and tried to fix it for him, and I'm sure as hell going to charge him, but I don't think he's getting value for money. But that's not from my side, it's from the machine. But hey, there you go. I mumble on sometimes. Okay, well, hopefully you've enjoyed this video. I know I have. No, I have, it's all right. It was fun to see it work at the end. And to work on something a bit different, something I really had no idea about. I'm sure Steve Robb will have some comments on this one. as will the posse, no doubt. Now, if you found it interesting, then why not subscribe to the channel? Click on subscribe, you'll see a little gear icon if you want. Click on the gear icon and then you can turn on, tick the box, and turn on notifications. That way our friends at YouTube will send you an email as and when I upload any new videos. And there's quite a few going up at the moment. I'm working pretty hard. But soon it's going to slow down. I'm back at Unitech next week. Crap. Okay, back at Unitech next week. And then we look forward to semester one again, all new students. Here we go. What else? You'll also find me on Facebook, Instagram, Google+, and Twitter. And feel free to communicate through any of those portals. But I would ask, first port of call, to communicate through the comments section of YouTube. And that way, your initial contact is right next to the video that you're relating to. And if I answer your question that you've asked, and it may be the same question that somebody else has, and they'll see me answer, and then it's going to get them, you know, a bit further forward with their problems as well, hopefully. Okay, crew, well, I've got a yard to go and sweep. Cheers for now. Over and out.